So this is the VT graph that is given to us, and by observing this VT graph, we have to find two bits of the questions. First is the difference between the distance traveled by the car and scooter. First of all, this motion that you can see, this motion is the motion traveled by car, and this dotted line represents the motion of scooter. So by observing this graph, okay, with the numerical values given to us, we need to find the difference between the distance traveled by car and scooter in 15 seconds. This is to be underlined in 15 seconds. Okay, so first of all, we have to find the distance that the car has traveled in 15 seconds, and after that, we have to find the distance that the scooter has traveled in 15 seconds. Then we have to find the difference. That is very simple. Okay, so we will start with the first bit. So distance of the car in t is equal to 15 seconds will be, we know one property that if there is a VT graph, okay, if there is a VT graph and this is the curve, then the area under that curve gives us the displacement of the body. Okay, so this property is being used here. So the area under its VT graph, the area under its VT curve will give us the distance that the car has traveled. Okay, so we will, the motion of the car is up to here, but we will take only up to this because the time has been given to us 15 seconds. So we will take the curve of the velocity time of the car up to 15 seconds only. So this is the triangle that we will be taking into consideration and whose area we will be finding out. So the area of this triangle will be half into base into height. Okay, that's the basic formula. So the base length will be from 0 to 15, that is 15, and the height will be 45, from 0 to 45, as you can see. Now the area will be half into 15 into 45, that comes out to be 337.5 meters. Okay, so this is the distance that is traveled by car in 15 seconds. Okay, so now we will find the distance of scooter in 15 seconds by applying the same method, then we will find the difference. Okay, so area under the curve of the VT graph of the scooter, that is this represents the curve of scooter. So area under that curve will give us the displacement. So we will find the area of this curve up to 15 seconds only, not up to 25 seconds, as in the question is given itself 15 seconds. So basically we need to find the area of this rectangle. So we know the formula of area of rectangle, that is length into breadth. So the length of this rectangle will be 30 and the breadth will be 15. So simply we need to multiply those two numbers, that is 30 into 15, that comes out to be 450 meters. Okay, now we will be taking their difference as demanded by the first bit of the question. The difference will be 450 minus 337.5, that comes out to be 112.5, which will be the final answer of this question. Now let's move on to bit number 2. So let's move forward to bit 2, that is asking us to find the time when the car and scooter will meet each other or will catch up each other. As you can see from the diagram from here, that we are assuming the car will meet the scooter after t seconds. So after t seconds, they would have covered equal distance, obviously, as they have started from the same point. If you cannot understand this, you must imagine two bodies starting from the same point. The velocity may differ and doesn't matter. If they meet at a point, so it's obvious that they have covered the same displacement. Okay, now 30t is equal to 675 by 2 plus 45 into t minus 15. You may be wondering what is the equation and what is the reason behind writing these equations. So this is the basically displacement covered by the car, and this is the displacement covered by the scooter. As I have said, the displacement covered by the car and scooter at t will be same, so we will equate the displacement of both the bodies and then find the value of t at which they will meet each other. Okay, so this is the displacement covered by the scooter and this is the displacement covered by the car. Okay, now by solving the equation 675 by 2, that is 337.5, and by opening the bracket and solving for t, we get t is equal to 22.5. Now if you are wondering why we have written the t minus 15, so as you can see from the curve of the car, this is 675.2 gives us the area of the triangle, and 45 whole into t minus 15 gives us the area of the rectangle, in which 45 is the length of that rectangle and t minus 15 is the breadth of the rectangle. So the total area gives us the displacement of the car traveled in t seconds. Now 30t is equal to 337.5 plus 45t minus 675, and t is equal to 22.5.